Hi, welcome to this tutorial. I'm Peter Sundell and a field application engineer at Vector Sweden. This video is about understanding scopes in PREEvision.
In PREEvision, models can get large with millions of artifacts. Using scopes is a way to limit what should be loaded to the model view. It enables you to focus on a selection of the whole model and is a way to hide unnecessary model complexity, to pinpoint what you need in your daily work. In this graphical representation, the model contains three product lines, the SUV, the sedan, and the convertible. Connected to this, you see three clients, each using a scope that is tailored to the needs of the role. The function developer needs only the logical architecture of the SUV product line, that is 7% of the whole model. The component responsible works also with the SUV, but needs access to both the requirements and the hardware architecture that adds up to 12% of the model. The last example is the architect, who works with both the sedan and convertible product line and needs access to more than half of the whole model. The purpose of scopes is to make things easier by having less artifacts to navigate and faster by excluding unneeded data loaded to your client.
After login, PREEvision automatically opens the project in scope view, where you may find predefined scopes provided for you made by your organization. Or you can create and then build your own scope by drag and drop of artifacts from the model view. This may be one or more product lines you're working on. When you work in a multi-user environment, activating a scope is a mandatory step after the initial login to the PREEvision client. The artifacts added are found in the model view and will serve as root objects where all children are included. If you need access to a parent, that can be altered in the active scope. You can change the description and the name of the scope from the context menu or by hitting the F2 key. With several scopes defined, you can switch focus by deactivate or activate scopes, maybe if you need to work on a different product line. Having properly defined scopes tailors the data you need for your work and hide unnecessary model complexity. Starting with version 10.0, PREEvision provides different ways to indicate that artifacts are missing in the currently active scope. The Missing in Scope folder in the model view lists artifacts that are not included in your current scope but may be of interest to you. Examples of this can be hints that you should enlarge your scope definition or reorganize the model by moving missing artifacts to the proper location. By using the Scope Quick View, you can temporarily add artifacts to work within the model view without changing how the scope is defined. In the Property view, a yellow frame indicates that there are relations to artifacts out of your scope. On opening diagrams, you can select to load such to your current scope or if the diagrams should open in read-only mode. There are several sections in the help file that contains more details how to make the best use of the scope feature in PREEvision.